Thanks so much for tuning in. If you have something to share, please comment below. For more Wellness Woman videos, be sure to click the subscribe button below and check out my Facebook group, Wellness Woman 40 and Beyond. But most importantly, don't forget to love yourself and educate, encourage, and empower your mind, body, spirit wellness. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Lynnis Minutes, and welcome to all of the new members of the Wellness Woman group. I am so happy that we are now close to 3,000 women. I think I need about four more or something like that. So thank you to those of you who have shared the group to everyone, and thank you so much to all of you who have shared and the post and liked and commented on that. It makes a big difference. I really have this goal. I think I've told you about it before. My goal is to move the Wellness Woman group here on Facebook to 20,000 by the end of this year. I know that sounds kind of crazy, but that's what I'm going for. I had asked a question a while back about, you know, how you all feel when it comes to your own anxiety. Do you experience it often or almost never or occasionally or more than you would like? And it's amazing how many people marked more than what they would like and also often. And that is not unusual given the average age group that we have here in the Wellness Woman, because I am creating a course on this, and it's menopausal anxiety. There is such a thing as menopausal anxiety. Anxiety that seems to exacerbate after menopause or during menopause or premenopause. And it really is related to hormones and also related to lifestyle. Now, there are all kinds of treatments for menopause, and I talk a lot more about that in this course that I'm creating. But I just wanted to give you some things to think about, you know, things that kind of make you want to go, yep, that's me. Sometimes we just need to know that what you're experiencing doesn't mean that you're going insane. It doesn't mean that you've lost it. None of that. What it means is that your body is changing. None of us can do all the things we want to do at 20 or 30, or many of us, nor would we want to do that. What we want to do is figure out what we can do to thrive and to vibe, okay, which is being vibrant, intuitive, beautiful, and emerged in midlife. Because, you know, I believe that midlife doesn't mean no life. Midlife is just an opportunity, ladies. It's an opportunity to be your best self. And I know you hear that a lot about best self. But I think midlife is ideal because you have something that the 20-year-olds and the 30-year-olds just don't have yet. Life experience. So, menopause anxiety. First of all, what does it feel like? Well, These changes that we have in our body lead to all kinds of factors, and one of them is anxiety. You know, menopause occurs when periods have ended, and it is very normal to begin to feel anxious or depressed once perimenopause begins, but frequent severe feelings of anxiety or panic attacks are not unusual for some symptoms of anxiety. But having those feelings of worry or unsureness or nervousness during menopause is not uncommon. What causes this? Well, it has to do with the imbalance of hormones, the stress hormones, adrenaline and cortisol. Stress hormones are released in situations when you feel out of control, overwhelmed, or anxiety. And there's a lot of things that can cause these hormones to increase. But if you're already, or decrease, if you're already going through premenopause or menopause, your hormone levels are shifting. And then you add the everyday stress components of midlife. And some of the stress components of midlife, and I can just go for me, you know, becoming an empty nester, approaching retirement, you know, reaching the glass ceiling in your career, feeling like there's got to be something else that you want to do. Maybe that significant relationship has changed. Maybe it's ending. Maybe you're going through divorce. Maybe you're developing some obesity issues or chronic disease issues or other stuff with your health that you haven't dealt with before. Learning to be a parent of adult children. Man, is that an eye-opener. So many different things. Caring for your parents, you know, taking a look at the need after retirement of having a second job or wanting to have a second career. It's stressful. So you add that stress with the increase or decrease of cortisol and of adrenaline. And you start getting a couple of things that are happening. And one of them is the feeling of anxiety. So does low estrogen, for instance, cause anxiety? Well, women with low progesterone levels and men, let's say, with low testosterone levels are prone to anxiety. So estrogen can help stimulate the production and transportation of serotonin. And the body it prevents its breakdown. Therefore, when estrogen levels are low and serotonin is low, then you have an unstable mood and anxiety can develop. Now, there are ways to help you balance your hormones naturally. Of course, one way to find out what's going on with your hormones is to go to your doctor, have your panels drawn, and find out where you are in that whole conundrum of hormones. Then once you find out where you are, then you want to find out, okay, what is it that I'm going to do to help bring these hormones into balance? Now, of course, there's always hormone therapy. And as I've said many times before, I'm not anti-hormone therapy, but just be aware that there are side effects to hormone therapy. And one of them could be cancer. Breast cancer is one. But there, besides hormone therapy, there are other things you can do in terms of your food and movement, then that can make a huge difference in balancing your hormones. You know, once again, once you know better, you do better. There's some things you want to stop doing and some things you want to start doing. Definitely, to help balance your hormones, you want to make sure that you are eating enough protein at every meal. Now, for those of you who aren't meat eaters or aren't high meat eaters, you can still get complete proteins from supplements that are out there. And by eating tofu or eating rice and bean combinations or soybeans, there's so many ways that you can get full protein. So eating enough protein at every meal is very important. I cannot tell you how important it is to engage in regular exercise, ladies. That really helps with the serotonin. That one of the happy hormones that helps with the production of estrogen. It's important. So it's more than just getting in shape or losing weight. It really helps your hormone levels. If you've never exercised before, now is the time to do it. And it's not too late. I just saw an article about a woman who started exercising for the first time in her life at 60, but it saved her life. So it's very important. Also, we want to avoid sugar and refined carbs, you know, basically processed foods. Any processed foods, they almost always have sugar in it. You want to learn to manage your stress. Meditation is huge when lowering cholesterol levels. And you want to lower that cholesterol because it's already being produced in an abundance when you're in menopause, when you're premenopausal. So you add stress factors to it, and the cortisol level goes up, which also can contribute to the feeling of anxiety. So cortisol is huge, and meditation is one way to lower your cortisol. Also, you want to avoid overeating or undereating. Sometimes when we're stressed out, we don't eat enough. We got to find a way to force ourselves to eat because that's important to keep metabolism going and also to provide our bodies with the nutrients that are needed that keep us healthy. Overeating in the same token can cause a plethora of issues, not to mention obesity. You want to make sure that you're consuming healthy fats. Omega-3, which is something that the body does not produce, but you can get it in a supplement or in your food. It's good for the heart. It's good for the brain. But healthy fats are really, really important. I love like olive oil or the fat that comes from almonds. Oh, so many. Also, drinking green tea. I have a new love. It is the ground version of green tea. I add it to my smoothie almost every day. It gives me prolonged energy, plus I'm getting all of those antioxidants that comes in green tea. And eating fatty fish as often as possible. Salmon, mackerel, any of the fatty fish are so important. All these things, all the foods that I just mentioned, and the exercise can help you to balance your hormones. And that is the first step towards really feeling better in your mind, your body, and your spirit, is balancing the hormones. So I want you to really begin to find out more information on your own about how to manage menopausal anxiety. And if you're interested in taking the course, please just let me know. Either message me or put me a little comment in there, and then I'll let you know when the course is ready. I'm hoping that the course will be ready in about 2 or 3 weeks. I'm very excited about it. In fact, I'm going to be giving several little mini webinars based upon the Lynnis Minutes. They're very affordable, where you can get a plethora of information that's going to help you to stay well in your mind, body, and spirit. The Costa Rica trip, which is due to start on March 12th, I believe it is, has been pushed back to April 29th through May 5th. So for those of you who are interested in going and thought you couldn't go because it wasn't the right timing, I just wanted to let you know, and I'll be posting more about it. I am so excited about this. There's something that came up in my personal life that I had to take care of, so I had to push it back. But the good news is that I think it's going to be even better because I have more time to plan. I'll be back on Wednesday with another topic that I hope is going to give you great information to help you to thrive. Thanks a lot for listening, and God bless all of you. Bye-bye. Thanks so much for tuning in. If you have something to share, please comment below. For more Wellness Woman videos, be sure to click the subscribe button below and check out my Facebook group, Wellness Woman 40 and Beyond. But most importantly, don't forget to love yourself and educate, encourage, and empower your mind, body, spirit wellness.